Our roads are death traps, not only because the roads are bad, but also because we do not know how to drive safe. The statistics of deaths and injuries on our roads are chilling. And many of the people who are dying and are getting maimed are young people. And many of the people who cause the accidents are also young people. But there seems to be something new brewing. Over the last 1 year, the Motor Vehicles Department of the state government has been doing a miraculous job. They have been clamping down. And very unusually, there's public support for the clamping down. No one is protesting, but everyone is supporting. And the one person who is making that change is Rishi Raj Singh, Transport Commissioner of the state of Kerala. He took over the mantle about a year ago and clamped down. He is a one-man army trying to make our roads safer. And as our celebrity guest today on Driving Safe, Driving Smart, we have Rishi Raj Singh with us. Welcome, Rishi Raj Singh, to Youth Express. Were you surprised that you're getting so much support from the public for being strict?
We started I joined in June 2013 only. Well, just completed 6 months.
Oh, less than 6 months.
Yes, sir.
So seems like 6 years.
Yes, sir. So in September only we started this after these two very tragic accidents which happened in Malappuram, one in Perinthalmanna and one in Tirur, where in total 32 people died. So then I found out the causes, and then I told my officers that at least let us start implementing what we have in our hand, what Central Motor Vehicle Act says, which was passed in 1988. So I found there are two things which were not being implemented. The one was for compulsory uses of helmet for bike riders, bike and scooter riders. And secondly, the implementation of speed governor compulsorily in all the stage carriers, including the private buses, lorries, tankers. So initially for implementing the speed governor, there was a lot of resistance. Even they threatened to go on a strike and all, but the strike was cancelled due to the public pressure within 1 hour. Within 1 hour, the strike it got its failure.
That was
so because you, നമ്മുടെ നമ്മുടെ മലയാളത്തിൽ പറഞ്ഞാൽ നമ്മുടെ നിയമത്തിന് മുമ്പിൽ ചർച്ചയുടെ പ്രസക്തിയില്ല. I said, then there was the minister called the meeting, and they say that, I say, sir, this is what the government of India told us to do. It's a central act and we have to implement it. These are the rules, these are the position. Minister, the government, everybody agreed, and they say that you go ahead with this. So that we are doing.
Rishi, we have got three young guests to discuss the subject with you today. Our first young guest is Melvin. Melvin, you studied abroad.
Yes, sir.
For over 12 years.
Yes, sir.
Do you think there's a big difference between what you've seen and in wherever you were abroad?
Yes, sir. Absolutely.
And India. And absolutely. Kerala especially.
Yes, sir. Absolutely. I was brought up in Muscat, sir. So what I have seen is in Muscat and other GCC countries, there are more strict rules for ensuring the issue of license. People have to go through 6, 7, 8 rounds, you know, to get the license. But here it is, it's a cakewalk. Everyone has a license. You know, you don't need to know the rules. You just need to know here and there you just know how to tilt the steering wheel left and right. You have your license in your hand.
Let me introduce our second guest, Gokul. Gokul is an engineering student. Have you ever been in an accident, Gokul?
I've been in a small accident, but I haven't been in any major ones.
Do you drive?
Yes, I do.
If I want to ask you the one thing Rishi Raj Singh should change to make Kerala safer, the roads safer, what would you suggest?
Straight roads don't make good drivers. So we need to see that at the time of obtaining licenses itself, candidates are good enough, you know, to obtain a license. So that is, I believe, the first step that we should take towards, you know, better.
Our third young guest is all of 15 years old. She is studying in the Saraswati Vidyalaya. Do you know anybody who's your near friend, your relative, who's been, who died in an accident, who's been injured badly in an accident?
One of my cousins, they had passed away in a bike accident. And it was very tragic. It just happened within seconds, and he was injured very badly. He passed away that night.
Bikes are a cause of accident. I'll come to that later. But the point that Melvin said, is obtaining a driving license very easy in Kerala?
It's not that easy. You see, when I go to RTO office or joint RTO office, I always see what is the percentage of passing and failure in the exam. It is 60-40%. For the current information, 40% people are failing. Only 60 are passing. You might have been a good driver. That is why you feel like that it's in a cakewalk. So if you are a good driver, then why we should harass you? We should give you, you have come to obtain a license, and if you, as per the license which Government of India has given us the guidelines how a driving license should be.
Do you think those guidelines need to be changed? I mean, you're implementing it.
We are implementing it. It is fine. I mean, this is a pre-learner's license. We call the person. If he has the basic knowledge, the test is on the computer itself. So if he passes it, then he is eligible for the main test. Then he comes over there after 28 days or so. If he's a good driver, according to us, I have found out the level of these driving tests in the other states. And ours is, I can tell you for sure, it is the toughest. So we have a test which everybody knows. If he passes, then he gets the license.
Gokul, Melvin, you're smiling. Do you agree?
Sir, I was saying about the guidelines. Even I feel the guidelines have to be changed. As in, what happens here is you can't really understand the practical knowledge of a person. Driver instinct by evaluating him for 10 minutes. You have to actually analyze each specifics. For example, the clutch balance, how he drives in high speed, low speed. All these factors have to be taken into consideration.
Is obtaining a license one of the causes for accidents? Would you say that?
I don't think so. And in any case, as you were saying, we are now coming with the computerized driving centers. Now already we have started in Calicut as well as in Kannur, where everything is computerized. So the way you drive over there, so the person is not standing near to you, is standing in somewhere in the room and looking. It's all computerized. If you do any small mistake, that test is slightly tougher than what we have in the other districts. So once those kind of computerized driving centers come in all the districts, it will be more tougher. You see, what you should say is that getting the driving license may be easy, but then the difference which we have in India with the other countries is that once you get it, then it is almost, it's like your personal property. It remains with you always. So the cancellation of the license is something which we need to do urgently.
Can you cancel a license?
We can cancel the license.
Does that happen very often, or is it only theory?
No, it is happening. No, there are seven conditions in as for a two. We are talking about the bike riding. There are seven offenses are there on which the license can be cancelled from 15 days to up to 6 months or so. Like talking over phone while driving. Rash driving, negligent driving under the influence of liquor, dangerous driving, etc. There are seven reasons on which, and we have been cancelling nearly 10,000 licenses we have cancelled in last 6 months.
To carry the discussion forward, do you think that I got a license? Now, as you said, that is permanent, it's my property. Do you think every 5 years, 7 years, I should again undergo a test to see that the license is renewed? Is that something that is a possibility? What do you say? Vaishnavi, you have a view?
Yes, I think so, because the first time you take the license, they'll be this good driver or a rider. But then later on, when they're on the road, they start harsh driving and they just rash out and they cause more accidents and all that.
When you come on the road, then we don't have a punching system. That is what they want to say.
Punching system
is you commit a mistake. Now, in India, we don't have the system. We have only just written to the government of India.
Some sort of a black mark.
No, it's one thing. Like in Muscat, he must be knowing, it's like this, there are 24 punches. So if you commit any traffic violation, so it is punched four times. So, and then you are told, and then there is a penalty for that. But he says, look, now four times it has already been punched. If that punching goes up to 24, then your license is taken away from you.
Let me move on. You spoke about bikes earlier. Bikes are a dangerous vehicle on the road. So they weave in and out of traffic. I'm scared when a bike comes at me. So you think we should do something about these bikes?
I don't think actually bikes as themselves are a problem. You know, drivers have to be more responsible. They are responsible for themselves and the person behind them. And like you said, if they get in an accident with, say, a car, even if it is their fault, it is the car driver who is ultimately blamed.